here to talk to you about this. It does look like a peppermint, but it's not. It's a tablet. So to be more precise, I'm here to talk to you about a tablet or medicine use. So in 2019, the National Center for Health Statistics of the United States reported that among the people they had asked, about 50% of them were taking a prescription-only medicine. Now, that is without considering the medicines that we buy over-the-counter without a prescription. So medicine use has become a commodity, thing that we cannot do without. These things are pretty amazing. Just imagine a day that you had a throbbing headache, an excruciating pain, and you don't have a medicine to make you feel better. Or a day that you were having chills and fever and vomiting and not having a medicine to feel better. Let alone that, what about medicines for diabetes? What about medicines for hypertension or blood pressure? Or for your heart disease? And I can go on with the list of medicines that we are so dependent on and can't do without. But I'm standing here right now. These medicines actually are very, very marvelous. These tiny as they are, they have this magic in them that makes us feel better when we are feeling bad. Right now, you and I are here probably because of medicines. But right now, I'm not standing here to talk about the marvel of medicines. I'm standing here to remind you and remind you again that these medicines can be a double-edged sword if you don't use them diligently. In fact, the medicines that can save your lives can kill you if you don't use them correctly. Okay, you can calm down because I'm also standing here to tell you about the three R's that I propose in using medicines so that you can make the best use of your medicines when you're using them. Three R's: respect, restrain, and report. So if you want your medicines to save your life, you need to respect your medicines. If your doctor or pharmacist has told you to take a certain number of units per time when you take your medicines, you need to just take that, not more, not less. If your doctor or pharmacist has told you the number of times a day that you have to take your medicines, you need to follow that. If your doctor or pharmacist has told you the duration or how long you should take your medicines, even if you're feeling better, like in antibiotics, you need to continue that. This is because before these medicines came into use or into the market, scientists have done a lot of studies, extensive studies to find out how these medicines work best in you. And so if you don't follow it, you don't get the best of it, out of it. Some medicines have instructions to make those medicines work better. For example, let's say you have to take your medicines after meals. You need to clarify how long after meals. That is, some medicines work better right after meals, but some don't. They work better way after meals. Some medicines have to be taken in an empty stomach. People do take it in an empty stomach, but then right after they take a big meal or drink a cup of tea, and then the medicines don't work. It's not that the medicines are bad. It's because you're not respecting your medicines. R number two, restrain. See, some people take their medicines according to instructions, but from time to time, they find these very creative little twists in their medication regimen to justify their desires or to find their comfort zones. Let me give you an example. Let's say I want to go for a party, and I think, I know that I shouldn't take medicines with alcohol. I go for the party, take my fair share of alcohol, I come home and I think, I shouldn't take my pill today because medicines and alcohol don't go together. Another example, this is diabetes patients. Especially in countries like Sri Lanka, where we have a lot of natural remedies. I think to myself, I shouldn't put chemicals into my body. They're bad for you. So let me listen to my friend who told me about this natural remedy that I can take for my diabetes and take my pill only every other day than every day. Or you see this big piece of cake in front of you and you have it for dessert and you think, I had too much sugar today, let me have two pills instead of my one pill per day. My friends, little do you know that this kind of fluctuations of medicine levels in your body is bad for you, it's bad for the body, it's strenuous for the body, and eventually it will affect badly on the other organs and they will also fail. It's worse than putting chemicals into your body. So, if you want your medicines to work well, you need to restrain from adding little self-initiated changes to the medication regimen and do what you like to do what you desire. Final R is report. When you take medicines, people do have problems. It's inevitable. Some people have unpleasant experiences. Some people have unexpected experiences. And sometimes you just can't follow the instructions you have been told to. And most people, when they encounter such things, they just drop their medicines or give up on their medicines. And unfortunately, they have to be, or their medical diseases or their medical conditions can get worse, and most of them can or have to be readmitted to hospital. Studies have shown that about 20%, and in some studies, about 60% of readmissions to hospitals were because of medicines. And about 70% of them were preventable. If you take the medicines that were responsible for these readmissions, among about 10, the most common three were medicines for heart disease, medicines for high blood pressure, and medicines for diabetes. And a good example is the diuretics, what we call the water pill. When water pill or the diuretic is taken, it makes you pee far more many times than you wish to. And most people just give up on that medicines. Unfortunately, most of them get their heart diseases worsen and they end up in hospital. So, sometimes, if you don't or if you give up on your medicines due to these reasons, it can eventually lead to another disease. For example, if you just give up on your diabetes medications, eventually it can lead to heart diseases and even a heart attack. So, if you want your medicines to work well, you've got to report to your doctor or pharmacist, and they should have a solution for you. Finally, if your medicines have to work well in you, and if a medicine has to save your life, you've got to respect them. Respect the drug regimen that you are being told to take. Restrain from changing or initiating little creative twists into the regimen so that you can do what you like. And report if you have a problem, when you have a problem, to the doctor or pharmacist so they can solve it for you. Thank you very much.